The following ritual has been adapted from George Hare's new book, Barbarous Words. I highly recommend this book and will leave a link to it below, along with George's YouTube channel, which is packed full of information and entertaining too. Today we're going to conjure a familiar spirit. A familiar spirit is a spirit familiar to the witch or magical practitioner. Mentioned in many numerous accounts throughout the witch trials, the familiar spirit is a helping spirit which carries out the witch's will in return for the witch feeding it. When communicating with familiar spirits, it's good to barter. Don't be afraid to ask it what it can and can't do and what it would want in return. Offerings to strengthen and satisfy the spirit can vary, but traditional offerings for familiars are bread, milk, or blood. Traditional forms of familiars can vary also, from animals, an amalgamation of animals, mythical creatures, fairies, or they can appear imp or demon-like. To do this right, you'll need a spirit vessel, a home for the spirit being conjured. And always ask the spirit's permission and consent. You don't want to conjure and house a spirit that doesn't want to be there. Okay, let's walk together. So to begin this rite, you'll need some water collected from a south flowing river for healing, and water collected from an east flowing river to bring life to the vessel. In folk magic, south-flowing streams are a natural source of healing, and to me, streams which flow from west to east bring dead things to life, as west is often seen as the direction of death, and east, the direction of new life. This is because the sun sets and dies in the west, and rises and is birthed in the east. Here we're using a skull and bones from the same animal as a spirit vessel. I take the healing waters from the south flowing river and using my left hand, I make counterclockwise movements on the spirit vessel to banish any hurt or trauma it has experienced in its life and in its death. I apologise on behalf of my species for any man-made ill or cruelty it has experienced. Speak words of love and encouragement as I heal the creature. Next, we make our working ground. We conjure the circle of art. Gather anything you'll need. Erect the stang. Make the conjuration triangle around the stang, making sure it's big enough to hold the spirit vessel. I place fire lighters on the points of the triangle and light them. And taking some fumigatory herbs, I begin saining the vessel, blessing it by air and fire, and bestowing these virtues upon it. I use the right hand and work clockwise around the vessel. This is the hand of blessing, regeneration, healing. Next, you pour water from the East Flowing River onto the vessel. Be sure to add a pinch of salt to bless the creature with virtues of both water and earth. And then we breathe life into the vessel. The breath is seen as a life force in many ancient cultures throughout the world, and so can be a very powerful tool. These breaths should be breathed deeply, exhaled with the life force you wish to give to the familiar spirit as you breathe it to life. Sit with your familiar a while in silence. Contemplate the relationship you will have. Hold the spirit vessel to the sky and ask for a blessing upon it from the divinity of your choosing. Hold the vessel of wine to the sky and ask for the blessings upon your new familiar and yourself and the bond you will create. The wine then becomes a vehicle of this blessing from the divinity of your choosing. Pour the wine onto the vessel as its first offering. This is also reminiscent of giving the familiar spirit blood and life. Don't forget to offer yourself some too. You've just given life to a new friend. Thanks for watching.